Tuesday, where I take one ingredient and use it for two reasons. My name is Sarah Manoresi, and this is
Joshua,
and this is
Lauren.
And today we are coming to you with some recipes that your kids can make over the summer. Not only will it give them confidence in the kitchen, but it'll give them some, what do you call them? Life skills?
Laura's called them that, not me.
Okay, Laura calls them life skills. So, because I'm not going to college with them, and you know, future people will thank me for it. So these are a fun way of using tortillas, and we're gonna make breakfast tortillas today. Really, you can use them for anything. We're using corn. I like ones that are a little bit thicker because they're going to hold up a little bit better. So this is nice and warm, and Joshua's gonna slice the banana. And then this is a special kind of banana. These are manzanos. They're really small. They kind of have a taste of a little bit of apple and strawberry to them. I found these at Whole Foods. If you can't find them, no big deal. You can just get a regular banana, but sometimes we like to be fancy and do something a little bit fun and different. So as you can tell, Joshua is actually very proficient on the stove, but this is for kids who might be not have as great of skills yet, just using a butter knife to cut it up. And then Joshua's gonna take some peanut butter. Why don't you do the peanut butter first?
Oh, okay.
And we're gonna spread it. And you can use peanut butter, almond butter, Nutella. Nutella's probably not like the healthiest thing for you, but you can certainly use it. You can add some local honey to help with allergies and kind of thing. And it just really comes really together really quick, and they can make it for themselves.
Yeah.
And maybe let you sleep in the morning. Maybe.
No.
Maybe not?
Yeah,
I don't know.
Sure.
Maybe
perfect,
they put themselves in and they're like, Mommy, I hurt my dad.
Or that. So if your kids aren't used to using knives, definitely always use safety and supervise.
Maybe.
But my kids
or
have
your
had
older
an
brother can help them.
Or your older brother can help or older unless sister.
Unless
now, Loris is making a breakfast burrito.
All right.
With some scrambled eggs that he's made. And how many eggs do you have in that pan?
Four.
Four, and we added about 4 tablespoons or so of low-fat milk. And this you can really do any way you want. If you're the mom and you like vegetables, you can add vegetables, saute them first and then pour the mixture over it. But my kids pretty much just like eggs and cheese. But really, any kind of cheese works. Feta, cheddar, Kobe Jack, those are some of our favorites. And so we've, again, heated one of these tortillas up. They are corn tortillas. That way you, what are you looking for?
Serving spoons.
They look back there.
Yeah.
That way, you know, like if you have a gluten allergy and just white processed sugar,
those
white flour, if you're trying to stay away from that, it's fine. So, we're just gonna take a nice little heaping helpful of the eggs and cheese mixture. And then you can add, we have some breakfast sausages on the side. I like Applegate Farms. It's no hormones added to it. The salt content is really like normal. I really like their products just across the board. That looks delicious, Joshua. And then you just fold it up. That's plenty of peanut butter.
Oh, I saved it. I am awesome.
Yes, you are. And then you just add in a piece of sausage. You can cut them up. You can add the mixture to that. Really, there's no wrong way of doing it. But whatever makes your family happy and makes them feel confident in the kitchen, these are two great, really easy recipes.
Just
and
fold it up and then eat it.
Yeah, I'll be right back.
And so while
we
he
got
goes,
we got
answers, as he answers the door, and as he starts chowing down, we hope you have a wonderful evening and hope these become family favorites of yours as well. Hope you're having a great evening and we'll talk to you later. Bye.
Just a package.
Bye. I like breakfast burritos.